In today's video, we're going to be installing Home Assistant on the Raspberry Pi with an SSD. Check it out. So in today's video, we're doing another install of Home Assistant on an SSD, but it's going to be a bit more in depth. So if you watched yesterday's video and you're looking for a bit more information, or maybe you just want to know more about the whole installation process, hopefully this video has got you covered. Or if you're after a quick snappy installation and you're familiar with setting up the Raspberry Pi images and Home Assistant installations, then check out that video from yesterday, because that's a bit quicker and it just brushes over some of the steps we're going to take a bit of time with today. So before we start, I just want to say a massive thank you to everyone that's like the videos, subscribed. We just hit 400 subscribers today, which is huge. Can I say thank you to everyone that's given me feedback on ways to improve, just any of the constructive criticism. It's all helped me a lot. If you have given me feedback, hopefully you've noticed that I've incorporated what you've suggested and try to improve on those things. And tomorrow I should have a video coming out that's going to recap my first week of YouTube, how I felt it's gone, what I've learned. I'm also just going to talk about a couple of things that I've got planned for the channel. So be sure to check that one if you're interested in some of the upcoming content. So enough rambling, let's get on with that installation. Just a little note, if you are watching this video after watching yesterday's quick installation video, there might be a couple of differences between them, and that's just because I've had a bit of feedback, so I've tried to change up some of the steps just to simplify them a bit more, just to make it more approachable for everybody else. And I'll try and highlight those changes as they come up. They are very tiny changes, but I'll point them out anyway. Okay, so why run Home Assistant on an SSD over an SD card? So the SSD runs a lot faster than the SD card, especially if you're using a Pi 4 which has the USB 3. And the same is true with other versions of the Pi, it's much faster to use an SSD over the SD card. The other big one is reliability. So SD cards with a Raspberry Pi are notoriously known for either becoming corrupt or for just dying. SD cards have a write life, and what this means is that over time, after a lot of writes, the card will start to degrade, and when that happens, that's when your corruption or card failure happens. Now, this doesn't mean that if you run your Home Assistant on an SD card, it's suddenly just going to die, but there is an increased chance of it happening. I've had Raspberry Pis and still have Raspberry Pis in the house that are running other things, and they're on 24/7, and I've never had an issue with them. But as this Pi is going to be running your Home Assistant, which is going to be managing and controlling various devices throughout your house, you probably want to increase that reliability and, again, increase that speed. So to do this installation, we're going to need a bit of hardware and a bit of software. Let's have a look at what we need. So first up, we're going to need a Raspberry Pi. In this video, we're using the Raspberry Pi 4. Now, the Pi 4 comes in a couple of different versions. There's a 2GB, 4GB, and an 8GB. In this video, we're going to be using the 8GB version, but this tutorial will work on those other versions. Now, I don't know if this tutorial definitely works with old versions of the Pi. I haven't yet had a chance to try this on my Raspberry Pi 3B. That may be something I have a go at in a future video, if enough people are interested in that. But if you do know if it does work on the Pi 3B, then let me know in the comments below. Next up, we want an SD card. Now, any old SD card will do. This just needs to install the Raspberry Pi image onto the Pi so that we can use that then to update and tweak the Pi a bit before we put the Home Assistant image on. You're going to need an SD card reader, unless you've got one built into your computer already. Again, any old brand one will do. An SSD. For this video, we're using the Kingston 240GB SSD. A SATA to USB 3 cable. Now, I have read some articles stating only certain SATA to USB cables are working at the minute, but this particular one does work, and this is a StarTech SATA to USB 3 cable, and you'll want it to be USB 3 in order to get those better speeds. You're also going to need a power supply that's capable of powering the Pi and the SSD. In this video, we're using the official Raspberry Pi USB-C power supply. Now, if you are using one of the more cheaper power supplies, just make sure it's outputting enough power for both the Pi and the SSD in order to not run into any issues with that. And the final bit of hardware you're going to need is an Ethernet cable. Now, you can set up Home Assistant to be run wirelessly from the Pi, but it's not recommended, and I'm not going to be showing that in this video. So that's all the hardware we need. Now let's have a look at the software we need. So there's a slight change in the software needed if you're coming here after watching the quick installation guide. And that change is just that we're going to make better use of one of the pieces of software, which actually eliminates one of the downloads we need. So less downloads, better for you guys. Now, if you're currently watching this thinking, this is a bit too slow for me, then check out that quick installation guide. It might be a bit more up your street. And if you're currently watching this and you're not subscribed, then hit that subscribe button below. So we're going to need the Pi imager, and this is going to allow us to write the Pi image onto the SD card. It's then also going to allow us to flash the SSD with the Home Assistant image. And thank you to Adam on Reddit for suggesting this. This eliminates the need to use Etcher. Next up, we're going to need an SSH client. For this video, we're going to be using MOBA Xterm. So you can use any SSH client you like. I personally like MOBA Xterm, so I'm going to use that. Another popular one to use is PuTTY. And as a bit of background for people that aren't familiar with this, what this bit of software will allow us to do is essentially remotely connect to the Raspberry Pi through a console, and we'll be able to just enter a few commands then to manipulate the Raspberry Pi. We're also going to need a blank SSH file, and while this isn't a bit of software, it is a file that we're going to need for the installation, so let's just create that now. So if we hit the Windows icon and type cmd and just hit enter, that'll open up our Windows command prompt. And then from here, we want to just type cd desktop, which will change our directory to be our desktop. And then from here, we want to just type SSH with the little bracket in the middle and hit enter on that. And what that will do is it will create this blank SSH file here, which we'll need later on in the installation. So the last bit of software we're going to need is going to be the Home Assistant image, and you can get this from the Home Assistant website. And for this video, we're going to be downloading the 64-bit version for the Raspberry Pi 4. So go ahead and download that and just save that on your desktop. Still following along? So that's all the software and all the hardware that we're going to need for this installation. So I'll have links in the description below for the hardware that I've used in this video. So check those out if you want to buy the same things or just have a look at the specs of what I've used. There's also going to be links in the description below for all the software that you're going to need if you want to check those out now and download and install them ready to go. And while you're down there grabbing those links, click that subscribe button. Okay, so at this point you've installed the Pi imager and you've chosen your preferred SSH client. So now we're going to put our SD card in the card reader and plug that in. Next, we're going to open the Pi imager, and then from here we're going to go choose OS. We're going to choose the Pi OS, choose the SD card, and we're going to select our SD card and click write. That's then going to start writing the Pi image to the SD card, and it might take a few minutes. Once that's finished, you'll get a pop-up to say it's complete and that the SD card can be removed. We're just then going to hit continue on that and close down out of the Pi imager. Okay, we then want to open up the File Explorer. In the File Explorer, you'll see two partitions for your SD card. One of the partitions should be labeled up as boot. Now, if you can't see the boot drive, if you just take your SD card reader out and plug it back in, the boot drive should then appear. So open your boot drive, and then we want to take this SSH file that we made earlier on and just drag that into the root directory. You can then close that, and we're going to safely eject the SD card. So the installation that we're doing now is known as a headless installation. So this is where you install everything without the need for a keyboard, mouse, and monitor plugged into the Pi. So super handy, and what that little SSH file does is it gives us that ability to start that remote connection to the terminal. Okay, so now we're going to put in our SD card, put in our Ethernet cable and our power, and we should see the Pi come to life. While we wait for the Pi to boot up, we're going to just carry on and flash the SSD in order to save a little bit of time. Now we're going to take our SSD and SATA to USB cable and plug that in. We're then going to open up the Pi imager again, and we're going to go choose OS. Use custom, and we just need to find the Home Assistant image that we downloaded earlier on, select that and open. We then need to click choose SD card, and we're going to select our SSD and then click write, and we want to press yes to confirm to erase the disk. That should then start writing. This should be a lot faster than the SD card, but we'll just need to sit and wait for that as well. Again, we'll get a pop-up to say that's complete. We can just click continue and then safely eject that as well. So now we have both the SSD and the SD card flashed, we're going to pop into our SSH client and start modifying the Raspberry Pi. Okay, we're then going to want to open up our preferred SSH client. In this case, we're using MOBA Xterm. So once you've opened your SSH client, there's two different ways we can use to connect to the Pi. You can either use the Pi's IP address, or you can use the Pi's hostname, which is raspberrypi.local. Okay, so we're going to use the local hostname, and we're going to start a new session. And it's an SSH session, and we're going to enter raspberrypi.local and OK to that. Okay, that will take us to the login page then, and we're going to log in as the user Pi. And the password for this is raspberry. So now that we're here logged into the Pi, there's a few commands that we're going to need to run through. Once we've done that, we can get Home Assistant on the Pi. Okay, first up is the command sudo raspi config. And what this will allow us to do is go into the configuration menu in order to configure various settings for the Pi. And we want to go to option 3, which is interface options. And we want to go to the second one down then, SSH, and enable that. Just press yes. And what that's going to do is allow us to SSH into the Pi. So we had to add that file in before. But what happens is after the first boot of the Pi, that file is removed. So if you accidentally turn your Pi off before enabling this setting, you'd then have to manually drag that file back on again. So this is going to allow us to do that SSH without needing to drag that file over each time. We then want to just hit enter on that and go to finish. We're then going to want to enter our second command. And with this one, we want to change the word critical to be stable. So just change that to the word stable. And then you want to hit Control X, the key Y, and then enter. So this is going to update the boot firmware and tell it to use all of the latest stable versions of the software when it does all of its next updates. We're then going to carry on with our third command, sudo app update. You'll know once that's finished because you'll see your username there with a little dollar on the end. Okay, we're going to run our next command now. This one's going to take the longest probably. You'll see a message saying, do you want to continue? You'll need to enter Y and hit enter in order for that to carry on. This is then going to run through updating all the packages on the Pi. And again, once that's done, you'll see your username there with the little dollar symbol. Okay, next command. We're nearly done with these commands now. So we're going to want to enter sudo reboot. And what this is going to do is it's going to restart the Raspberry Pi. So give that a minute to reboot. You'll then need to reconnect your SSH client. If you're using MobileX Term, you can just hit R then to restart that session, and then you'll need to log in again. Okay, next command, and this one's going to check the EEP ROM version. So here we want to check, so we've got the current version that we have installed, and then the latest version. If these both match up, then we're good to go. We're then going to want to open the config tool again by doing sudo raspi config. And then we're going to want to go down to number 6, advanced options. Choose that, then we're going to click boot order, and we're going to say USB boot. That will enable USB boot, click OK then, so just hit enter. We're then going to go back into advanced options, and we're going to say bootloader version, and we're going to say latest version, and it's going to say do you want to reset, and we need to make sure that we hit no here, and OK. We can then go to finish. And it's going to ask us if we want to reboot. Just hit yes there. And again, just give that a second. Restart the terminal and log in. So this one's an optional one, but it's a handy command to find out what your IP address is. And you can use this IP address then to connect to Home Assistant. So we want to type ifconfig minus a and hit enter. And you'll then see your Pi's local IP address. And that'll be the address that we can use then to access Home Assistant. You can also use this in the future for connecting to your Pi instead of using raspberrypi.local. Okay, and then the final command is going to be sudo shutdown minus h now, and that's just going to shut the Pi down. We can then close down the SSH client, unplug everything from the Pi, take out the SD card, then we're going to plug in the SSD, plug everything back in, and boot the Pi up. So the same deal here as before, plug all the cables back in, plug in the SSD, and the Pi should start booting up. We're then going to want to open up a web browser, and we've got two choices again for how we can connect. We can either use the Pi's IP address, or we can go to homeassistant.local:8123. Once that has loaded, you'll get a page like this, and from here we can create a user account. So just fill this in with your name, username, and password. The credentials that you set here are going to be the credentials that you use to log into your Home Assistant instance. So fill those in and hit create account. It's then going to ask you to name your Home Assistant instance, set your location, choose your time zone, and set your unit system. So fill those in again. Once you hit next, it's going to ask you if you want to add any integrations. If you wanted to add these now, you could hit the more and then choose your integration type. In this run through, we're not going to do that. We're just going to hit finish and it will take us to our first dashboard. So there we have it, guys. That's been another run through of installing Home Assistant on an SSD. I hope those of you that wanted this more descriptive version have found this helpful and you've been able to follow it better. If I missed anything or you're still unsure of anything, let me know in the comments below and I'll try and help you out as best I can. In the future, we're going to be navigating around this dashboard to learn where everything is. We're then going to start adding our own integrations and automations and get started with the fun stuff of Home Assistant. And for those of you that have been asking about porting over your SD card build to this new SSD version, I will also have a video of that coming out where I'll be moving my Home Assistant instance from the SD card to the SSD. So thank you for watching. If you found this helpful, please give the video a like, drop a comment below, and consider subscribing. And I'll catch you in the next one.